out of shot.
You get out of shot, then no one knows you're here. Although in a very YouTube jump cutty way, I might now use that. More of this, like, oh, it's just the... Again, you can chop together, seamless. Should we start?
Hey.
Morning. I'm at Lostock Hall. It is time to do some more request stops. Today, I'm on the East Lancashire line. Now, normally, we need to address this immediately. When I do a least used station, I very definitely have a companion. Request stop videos usually don't have a companion. However, in the history of least used stations, my friend Carl, who's from Manchester, has joined me for Hosca, as well as Stanlow and Thornton. And he also joined me once on a ride we just did on the old Reddish South and Denton, which is why I'm thrilled today that Carl, at a distance, is here again. So you're my exception to the rule.
Exceptional friend.
Oh, you are my exceptional exception friend. Is this sign in the way? Let's go ride some trains. So on my request stop map, we're ticking off three more in the Lancashire area.
And we're going through Huncoat, which used to be a request stop.
Yes, used to be a sticky handout job, yeah.
A sticky handout job, yeah.
Request stops are now known as
stick your hand out stations.
Stick your hand out stations.
In the days of yesteryear, I would have expected a pacer, but now you think round that corner in a second, it's going to be one of the Northern's new toys, which is what you once famously said.
You know what? I won't put any money on that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Is it the next stop? Normally I'd sit next to you. When I'm in London, travelling now, it's fascinating to watch on the London Overground, where you get the seats that are side by side, rather like that. Like, no one's told us to do it. As humans, we've just all sensibly gone, oh, I will no longer sit next to anybody. So you get person gap, it's just naturally happened. It's brilliant to watch. Yeah. So now, in the height of the rush hour, you get trains with seats and no one's sitting on them. So I'm not sitting next to you. I've spoken to a guard, I've requested Bamber Bridge first, I've requested Pleasington. First request stop of the day.
Next
stop is Pleasington.
She just said
Pleasington.
It's Pleasington.
Whoa. Oh, step down.
Do you think Pleasington or Pleasington?
Oh, there is Pleasington.
But on the company announcement, they say Pleasington.
Definitely Pleasington.
Pleasington, right.
Pleas, isn't it? Yeah.
Thank you so much. It is a community rail partnership. The CRP people will be waving right now. Hello, we came to Pleasington. But look, the pirate's way to Cherry Tree. Hang on, is that Comic Sans?
Yeah, it is, isn't it?
Someone's used Comic Sans. It's a little walking route. But what? We were going to go along the canal, but they're saying that you can take a little... Ah. Oh. But the amazing thing that you've noticed, Carl, are the signs.
Apart from your bog standard northern one, we have four rather pleasantly, see what I've done there? Pleasantly coloured signs. And I've noticed there's spring on this one. And because there's four, there's one for each season. Look, isn't that lovely?
So all four seasons are covered?
All four seasons are covered.
That is very Pleasington, isn't it? That's very Pleasington to see.
Oh, we could go for miles, can't we, with this gag, I'm telling you.
Yeah.
A clue as to what used to regularly do this route. There you go.
Your pacer.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, when was the last time we were on a pacer?
Oh, black. It was with you when we did Hosca from Bursko.
Ah, Bridge or Junction, I always get this one wrong.
Hosca Bridge Junction? That was over a year ago.
That's Preston.
You've not been on a pacer in a year. They're still out there in places, right?
It's still knocking around like a bad smell.
Knocking around like an unpleasanton smell.
We really need a bit of fun, don't we?
So, quick check. Shelters, yes. Yep. Ticket machine, yes. Bins, yes. No dot matrix. Benches inside the shelters. Harrington hump, step-free access to both sides. No car park or shop. What'd I miss? I'm impressed it's got a ticket machine.
It's one of the new ones.
One of the new ones as well? Yeah. Why not Northern?
Bang goes my theory about there not being any of them on this line.
Well, no, they're maybe using those for the express services, and then the 158s for the stoppers.
Yeah, maybe.
We're talking numbers. This is not a train spotting vlog.
No, it's definitely not.
I don't know why I started that with you this morning.
We've gone down a rabbit hole.
Let's not do numbers. Is that a class 37? But the reason why you're my exceptional friend is because Carl is like my local fixer. You're like northern. You know what it's like? It's like on the BBC when they used to go, and now in our Middle Eastern correspondent, Kate Adey, right? I'm not saying you're Kate Adey, right? You're welcome. But you are like my northern correspondent. So imagine I'm on the BBC, and now to our northern, with an interesting thing that he's just spotted.
At the bottom of the, are they called totems? Flags? I don't know what you call it. Anyway, you see the NW at the bottom there, the grey and orange thing, that harks back to, is it late 80s, early 90s when, no, it's not even a franchise, it was a rebranding. It was before privatisation that all the railways around here were branded as Network Northwest. And it was given this grey and orange branding, and it's still there.
So like Network Southeast, but Network Northwest.
I've not seen one of those logos for years, honestly, because they slowly, obviously they replaced it.
See, now we've got a bit Star Wars. That's a name I've not heard in a very long time. Liverpool Canal. We've done a bit of canal walking.
Leeds and Liverpool.
Leeds and Liverpool.
There's a Leeds and Rochdale Canal which passes through Manchester.
Okay.
There's a Leeds, obviously Leeds and Liverpool as well.
But by hook and crook and foot, we just got on the train at Huncoat. Mm. Now Huncoat, for many years, wasn't a request stop. And when they made Burnley Barracks and stuff request stops, Huncoat, they also made a request stop. But then they unrequested it and it went back to a regular stop, and so we've just come to Huncoat to get on there, but it's not requested anymore. But instead of getting out of Hapworth, we're going to go to Burnley Barracks first, then reverse, and then come back and do Hapworth, which we're just about to pass through. But we'll do this third rather than second. Yes? Hapworth, I meant, what's it called?
Hapton.
I really should learn the name of the stations.
Apparently there was no need, because he says we're stopping at all of the stations anyway today. So today's request stop didn't need to be requested.
This is the northern service to Hull. The next stop is...
That's quite a lot of people. We're at Burnley Barracks. Quite a few people got off.
I know.
Did you
I'm
say
surprised.
That?
I am.
And it's now
I'm
single
surprised.
Track. As we approached, the two tracks went to one.
Yep.
And we're now on single track. So there was a barracks here, right?
Oh, yeah.
I feel this is definitely your territory. Again, BBC presenter, we go now live to Carl, our northern correspondent, to explain the history of the barracks at Burnley.
Thanks, Jeff. You join me now from Burnley Barracks that's not here anymore. It was built in 1820 and was in use until 1898. No, 1898, 1889, anyway. Hmm. There's very little of it remaining, if anything at all. It was used mainly for the infantry and for the cavalry. Carl Florjak, Northern England correspondent, Jeff Marshall, Channel.
So single track now, but there's obviously space where there was another track and another platform, and even the bridge there, you can see there's space for the track. So it's been doubled to singled at some point, clearly. Is there a bin? Is there a shelter? Is there a display? Is there a ticket machine?
Shelter,
yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Bin.
Yeah.
Wafting in the breeze.
But again, no timetables. No. When is the next train? Train's in about 20 minutes.
20 minutes. But there is, which I'm finding very surprising, is one of those lovely touchy screeny kind of tickety machines that Northern have brought out recently-ish.
I'm amused how there's like three stages of platform. There's the modern day with the visually impaired rumble strip. Then there's a bit which is fairly modern but no rumble strip. And then there's this third section down here that's the overgrown with nettle stage. Also, there's a river behind. What's the river? I've only just seen the river.
No, that's...
Come on, Northern Correspondent.
Sorry, you've thrown me.
Oh no, that is the canal.
That is the canal.
That we were walking along earlier. Yep. There's more of the canal.
Same
one. So it goes right over the canal here.
Nice.
Right, here comes our train. So we're going to Hapton.
Hapton.
Sweet.
The reason why, Jeff, I think this is quite a vanilla station. I mean, two shelters, not much else. The original buildings were demolished in the 70s. Obviously, the platforms still remain, but I think on the information board up there, there's something you can read about that.
Have you found Northern Correspondent?
Northern Correspondent has found a map. Hapton Station, though, for a map that's based at Hapton Station actually isn't on it. It's slightly just off the, map here. It's kind of there. So, there's Burnley Barracks. We've just come from there. And Hapton's it. And so, I think it's just pointing your way to the canal. And you've got Paddyham there, Gawthorpe Hall.
Here you go, Paddyham Greenway. The Paddyham Loop was open to goods traffic back in the 1870s. It's an old line. It's now a greenway, another old railway that's been turned into a greenway. We could do that, Carl, or we could go to the pub down by the canal.
Yep.
So Pleasington was
pleasant
and charming and nice, and Burnley Barracks was in a bit more
functional kind of thing, wasn't it?
Yeah. And Hapton is now quite dull.
Yeah.
A real kind of like. So, but Carl, down the road there is a pub by the canal. So I think we need to.
I think we need to exit stage left here.
Exit stage via the canal and a little drink to finish out. But that is it. That is three more request stops ticked off. There's one more to come in this area. You're not invited to that. I don't need my Northern Correspondent. Do you want to sign off though? Do you know, like, they sat on BBC News? They like shuffle the papers. You have to sign off.
This has been Carl Leff, Northern Correspondent, for Jeff Marshall.
Cheers, mate.
Thank you.